Hi, in this video I'll be answering one comment. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button super thanks. And if you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my video as it is fully uploaded, then hit the button join. Thanks. And that's this one. Here it says that I speak too much and I show nothing, and that I should show you how you find a code with a multimeter and how you delete, how you erase that code. Well, at the very beginning, to tell you, to disappoint you, is that such code cannot be erased with a common multimeter, with one like this. This is just a common multimeter that can measure voltage, amperage, resistance, etc. It has a buzzer. With such a multimeter, you cannot do that. And since that was the video on percentage, as I was showing, then you cannot do that. The percentage is a first form of some kind of a diagnostic. A diagnostic can show you that seven sensors and only seven sensors are not in a good shape. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. So only these seven sensors. So if you don't know how they are called throttle position sensor, coolant temperature sensor, sensor potentiometer, lambda probe, hole speed sensor, crankshaft position sensor, and air intake temperature sensor. And as a matter of fact, the only thing you can diagnose here is if a wire is loose, or it's interrupted, or something is not as it is supposed to be. That's the only thing you can do, and you cannot erase that code. You cannot. Well, to simulate now, as I cannot show how it looks like having an error in a Ke-Jetronic car, I can only simulate it like this using my multimeter. So let's look at the video. Now, I choose here percentage because we were talking about percentage. As soon as I turn the ignition on, the multimeter shows 70%. Why? Why 70%? 70% means that something is wrong with the crankshaft position sensor. So the ECU sees that and it thinks it's a code, it's faulty. Well, as the engine is off, then the flywheel is not rotating. And of course, as it is not rotating, then no RPM signal can be created, what the task of a crankshaft position sensor is. And of course, the cryogenic shaft position sensor can give no signal as the engine is off. Once we start the engine, we have to read 50%. Now this also can be a code, 50%. 50% refers to the lamp. But as I have already told you, it can also mean that it's not active if you have a cat version of your car. If you have a non-cat version of your Mercedes, then you have to get steady 50%. Once the car achieves operating temperature, then the percentage starts fluctuating and it looks like this. Now, as my car here is cold, then the ECU says that there is something wrong. Let's say it's a code, because it can mean either that the lambda is off, it's non-functional, or it still is not active because the car did not achieve operating temperature. If at 80 degrees you get fluctuation, then everything is okay with the car. Where you can actually erase the code, it's on X11/4. That's by the right fender, by the battery. One rectangular shaped thing, let's say it like that. And there, if you have a car starting from September 89 and further, that's fourth generation of KE, there you can diagnose that there is some code in your system. Just on those cars. On all the older ones, no, you cannot do that. So no way you can do that. And there you have port number 3 for injection. You have port number 6 for airbag, I believe, and number 7 for your AC. And that's what you can do with the most primitive one with 8 pins. Well, if you now have later versions of the car with 16 or more, 28 I believe, where you have also an electronic accelerator, where you have more sensors, then there, depending on the pulses, how many pulses you read, there you can see if you have an error in a system and how you erase that code. So, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then, I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one, happy Mercedesing. Bye.